हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम भावना शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ कॉमर्स, जेनटेक, ग्रेटर नोएडा. इन मैनेजमेंट अकाउंटिंग वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ मार्जिनल कॉस्टिंग. वी विल डिस्कस फ्यू अदर एप्लीकेशंस टुडे. फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस एक्सप्लोरिंग द न्यू मार्केट्स. नाउ द कंपनी हैज टू टेक डिसीजन रिगार्डिंग सेलिंग द गुड्स A new market, that is, new market can be in India or foreign market. Now, the company must consider that they have surplus capacity to meet the new demand. The price offered by the new market, that has to be considered, and whether the sale of goods in new market will affect the present market. So these points must be considered by a particular firm or company when they want to enter the new market. Now let's discuss an example that a company sells a product at rupees 36,500. Which is described as follows, that material used in that particular product is rupees 16,000, labor for rupees 2,000, fixed overheads to produce that product is 6,000, variable overheads in that product is rupees 5,500. Royalty, what they have to pay is 1,000, and their profit margin is rupees 5,000. Now the company has enough idle capacity that they want to enter a new market, and they can because they have additional capacity or enough idle capacities there. Now a firm in Arabia, they offered to buy 10 products at 28,500 each. Should the company be interested in the business? And second, that it has been decided to sell 5 products to X company under the same management at the bare cost. What price should be charged? Now, we are given certain cost for the company. So obviously, when we want to explore the new market, when we want to enter the new market, like in the first case, that they are offering to buy the products. So we have to consider the marginal cost for the product. So let's discuss this. So first, the company has to calculate the marginal cost. Now, whatever information is given in the question, we'll consider that. First, we are given material, then labor is given, fixed overheads is given, but we'll not consider it in marginal cost because only variable cost is considered, then variable overheads is considered, and royalty. So material is 16,000, labor is 2,000, variable overheads amount is 5,500, and royalty is 1,000. That means the marginal cost for this particular product is 24,500. The company is selling the product at 36,500, but the marginal cost for the product is only 24,500. Now, in first case, the Arabia firm is offering to buy the product at 28,500. So, if we whatever decisions are being taken, that is on the basis of variable cost or marginal cost. So that means the product marginal cost is 24,500. If they are offering 28,500, the company has a profit of 4,000. So the company can be interested in that business because the profit on selling these products to Arabia would be 4,000 each product, and they are offering to buy 10 products. And in second case, a company which is under the same management, they are deciding to sell 5 products. So at the bare cost. So bare cost means the total cost. So here we'll take obviously all the marginal cost plus the fixed cost also. So 16,000 is the material, 2,000 is labor cost, variable overheads is 5,500, royalty is 1,000, plus fixed cost is 6,000. That means the company can charge the price of 30,500, which is the total cost for producing a particular product. So, like this, we can take the decision of entering the new market. Now, next decision is discontinuing a product line. Now, the company may decide to discontinue the product line. Obviously, when a particular product or area or a department is not earning profit or may incurring losses, the company may decide to discontinue that particular product line. So some points should be considered by the company while they take the decision to discontinue a particular product line. That if a product or product line is dropped, there will be some disengaged capacity which may be left unused or may be used to increase the production of the product that are doing profit. Because when you discontinue the product or product line, the resources may be idle, which may be shifted to some other products. Second, if any factor of production is key factor, we have already discussed key factor or limiting factor in previous lectures, that which is available in limited quantity or the supply is short. So then the contribution should be expressed in terms of key factor per unit. Now following are the some principles that should be followed in taking decisions to drop a particular product, product line or department. That product which yields highest contribution should be given top priority in the production program. Non-product or product line should be dropped if it doesn't yield any amount of positive contribution. And if any factor is key factor, that product should be dropped as it which provides least contribution per unit of key factor. So let's discuss an example that a company manufactures 3 products, namely A, B and C. And the company's budgeted profit and loss is given in this table. Now, sales is given for product A, B and C. So sales for A product is 45,000, B product is 225,000. And C product sale is 30,000. So here we can see the sales volume is maximum in case of product B. Now look at the production cost. Production cost is the cost of production, which is bifurcated into two, which is variable cost. Variable production cost for product A is 24,000. For product B is 144,000. And for product C, it is 12,000. So we can see now fixed production cost is 3,000 in case of product A, 48,000 in case of product B, and 9,000 in case of product C. Likewise, we are given selling cost, which is again bifurcated into fixed selling cost and variable selling cost. So for product A, variable selling cost is 8,100. Same is the case of in product B, and in product C it is 7,800. Fixed cost for product A is 2,100. For product B, it is 1800, and for product C, it is 2100. Now, all this information is given to us. The board of the company has decided to eliminate product C. So, as an accountant, you have to advise that the company should discontinue with product C or not. So for this, we can calculate the contribution, profit, as well as the profit volume ratio. And then we can decide whether to discontinue with the product C or not. So for product A, 45,000 sales is given. In order to calculate contribution, we need to deduct variable cost with sales. So for variable cost, we have to take two things. So, sales is 45,000, and for variable cost, we have to take both the variable cost, that is variable production cost and variable selling cost. Now, variable production cost is 24,000. While variable selling cost is 8,100 for product A. So 45,000 minus 24,000 minus 8,100, or 24,000 plus 8,100 is 32,100. That means total of the variable cost, total of production variable cost and selling variable cost. So contribution for product A comes to rupees 12,900. Now, in order to calculate the profit, we have to deduct fixed cost with the contribution. Again, we'll take total fixed cost. That means production fixed cost and selling fixed cost. So production fixed cost is 3,000 and selling fixed cost is 2,100. That makes 5,100. So deducting 5,100 from 12,900, so profit for product A is 7,800. Now, on the basis of this information, we can calculate the PV ratio for product A. So contribution is 12,900 divided by sales is 45,000 into 100. So PV ratio for product A is 28.67%. Likewise, same information we can calculate for other products also. Now, sales for B product is 2,25,000. Again, deduct production variable cost and selling variable cost, which is 1,44,000 and 8,100. So the total of variable cost is 1,52,100. So deducting 152,100 from 2,25,000. So contribution of product B is 72,900. Now deduct fixed cost. So production fixed cost is 48,000 for product B and 1,800 fixed selling cost, which makes 49,800. So deducting 49,800 from 72,900, so profit for B product is 23,100. Again, putting values on the same formula, contribution 72,900 divided by sales, which is 2,25,000 into 100. So B product contribution is 32.4%. So as we have already seen in the information that the sales of product B is comparatively more. Likewise, for the product C, sales is 30,000, while variable production cost is 12,000 and variable selling cost is 7,800. So total is 19,800. So deducting 19,800 from sales 30,000 gives the contribution of 10,200. Then deducting the total fixed cost, which is production fixed cost is 9,000 and selling fixed cost is 2,100 for product C, which is 11,100. So 11,100 is a fixed cost, while contribution is less. That means the contribution is in negative. The company is not earning any profit in products D. That is why the company has decided to discontinue the product. Now calculating the PV ratio, that is 10,200 divided by 30,000 into 100 is 34%. So when we look at the contribution, maximum contribution is product B is giving. In case of profit also, product B is giving the maximum contribution, while product C is giving the negative contribution. But when we look at the PV ratio, profit volume ratio, we can see that C product is giving has the highest PV ratio as compared to A and B product. Now, what we recommend is that if the product C is discontinued, then the fixed cost of 10,200, which is being recovered now, that cannot be recovered. And if we also consider the PV ratio, it does not seem to be unprofitable as the PV ratio is 34%, which is maximum compared to other products. So in my suggestion, C product should not be discontinued as the profit volume ratio is maximum for product C. Thank you. That's all for today. We'll discuss few other applications in next lecture.